In this video, I'm going to tell you how to make soft phulka along with all the tips and tricks. Let's start with making the dough. So here I've got whole wheat flour or gehu ka aata, 1½ cup. To it, add some salt. Some people prefer to not add salt, but this is how I have always seen my mom make roti. So I'm adding salt. Now add a little water at a time, total 1/2 cup. Plus 1 to 2 tablespoon water is what you're going to need. So we are going to make this dough semi-soft, not too hard, not very loose. So you need to knead the dough till the dough comes together. Cover it and rest it for at least 5 minutes. You would have seen that the dough was a little rough on the surface, but let's see it later. Now meanwhile, very important thing. So these are the two different types of rolling pins or balans which I have got. So this one you can see it has got sharp edges. Okay, so the sharp edge balan is a little difficult to work with if you are new. And if you're new to making rotis or do not find it easy to make perfect round rotis and this is the perfect design, see this balan has got tapering ends. The one I'm showing you right now is a little thinner one. It's actually used for papad, but in the same design you do get the thicker ones in the market very easily. It's not like this balan is not good for making rotis, but just that it needs a little practice to make perfect round rotis with this balan. It's been 10 minutes and now again we need to knead this dough for 30 to 40 seconds and after this you would notice that the dough becomes really nice and smooth. Take out a portion or loi from this dough. So this is what it should look like. Take your chakla, apply some dry flour or atta and start rolling. So this is the tapering balan which I'm using, and while rolling, remember do not apply a lot of pressure, little pressure, and you need to start working on the sides. Make sure to make good rotis, the sides should be thinner compared to the center. So here I've got my iron tawa, it's at high flame. So first you need to roast the roti on one side for 7 to 8 seconds, then flip it. Rotis become hard or stretchy if you make them at low flame. Using a cotton cloth, press the sides of the roti like this so that they get cooked evenly. And then I'm removing the tawa and placing the roti directly onto the flame. So before placing, I lower the flame. After placing, I increase the flame so that it puffs up. Okay, I have the habit of lifting the roti with my fingers, but you can also use the chimta. So now let me tell you the problem which I was talking about with this balan if you're not used to it or if you're new to making rotis. The sharp edge of this balan tends to apply more pressure on a particular area of the roti and you do not get round roti, or sometimes the sides come out like this, what you see on the screen. If you also have both the types of balans at your home, do try them out and let me know if you also find this difference. Okay, I have the habit of making roti with this balan as well, so I am comfortable making phulka chapati with this. So let me show you one with this balan also. But this was a quick tip from me. Choosing a right balan will also help you make better rotis. So the same process, 7 to 8 seconds on one side, then flip, and after flipping you need to cook the side completely. Use a cotton cloth to cook the edges and the flame should not be low. You can keep between medium to high if you're not used to cooking your rotis at high flame, if you find it difficult or your rotis are burning. Phulka is incomplete without ghee for me, but if you do not want to apply ghee, you can leave the phulkas just like that. So as you go on making rotis, when you are done with two, apply the ghee and keep them in your hot pot or whatever container you have for your rotis. Now another thing which I wanted to show you is that if you are not comfortable in puffing up your rotis by placing them directly on the burner, you can do this. So after pressing the edges, flip the roti and put it back on tawa only instead of burner and the phulka will puff up. What my mom does is, instead of a cotton cloth, she keeps another phulka on top of the bottom phulka and she uses that to puff the one which is on the tawa. You can do that also. So here is my roti ka dabba. You need to keep your phulkas or roti in a cotton cloth, otherwise the steam from the rotis will make them soggy. So our roti or phulke have come out really nice and soft. So you need to knead the dough properly and you need to cook the phulka or roti at high flame or between medium to high at least. Do not cook them at low flame. and that way your phulkas would remain nice and soft for longer duration. Give this recipe a try and follow all the tricks and tips which I have explained, and you would be able to make nice, soft and phula phula phulka. Enjoy!